Building out interactive experiences just got a whole lot easier in Adobe XD with the addition of fixed elements and overlays. Let me show you these capabilities in action. With fixed elements, you can define components that remain fixed or pinned while everything else scrolls on an artboard. For example, I'm working on this iPad design. Now, it's kind of a long scrolling page, and I've set the artboard up to support that. Notice when I click on the artboard in the Properties Inspector, it indicates that I've set it up as a vertical scrolling page. I have the indicator here that shows where that default viewport will be. What I want to do now is pin each of the individual header and footer items. To do that, all I need to do is click on the item I want to be fixed. This is a group of both navigation and my header elements. With it selected, click on Fix Position. I'll select the footer elements and do the same thing. If I click on a desktop preview of that page, notice as I scroll down how that header remains fixed, the footer's fixed. In fact, I've set a background blur in the header area. Notice how it's dynamically rendering that background image. Now, this will be true for design specs and prototypes on the web, so I get a nice, consistent experience. Next up, let's take a look at overlays. For this portion of my design, I'm working on an iPhone layout. And often when you're prototyping, there are elements that you end up repeating across multiple artboards. And to show states, you end up duplicating way more content than you should. With the overlay feature, what I want to do is have it such that all three of these artboards that have navigation at the top, when you click on the hamburger menu, I want a drop-down menu to occur, this menu here on the right. When you click on the search icon, I want a keyboard to slide up with a search field. It's really easy to do this with the overlay feature. Here in the prototype mode, I'm going to come in and select that hamburger menu, and I'll drag a wire over to my menu. When I release, I want, instead of selecting a transition, I want to choose an overlay. And the behavior I want here is for the object to slide down when you click on the hamburger menu. Notice I get a positioning indicator there on the left. My artboard for my menu is smaller than the actual artboard it will appear on. That's fine. I can drag it up until it's just on top of the original content. I get a nice onion skinning behavior here. For the keyboard slide up, I'll do pretty much the same thing. I'll come on in and grab that magnifying glass. I'm going to drag a wire over to the keyboard. Once again, select overlay, and in this instance, instead of sliding down, I'll go ahead and slide up, and I'll make sure I position it towards the bottom of my screen. Let's take a quick look at my work. I'll go ahead and bring up my preview window, and when I click on the left with the hamburger menu, I get a nice drop-down. I could click to any other menu item if I have that linked, or just click off to dismiss it. When I come over to the magnifying glass, I get that nice interactive slide-up of the keyboard that indicates how I would have a search field with a keyboard. I encourage you to give these terrific interactive prototyping features a try.